Oh, so we can just say as much shit as we want. I sit here and I sometimes like saying to myself, 2020, I want to learn how to stop making my hands do the peace sign for everything.
Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. My name is Kayla and on today's video...
In 2020, Megan's gonna stop doing the peace sign.
Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. My name's Kayla, and on today's video, we have my twin sister Megan here.
Hi.
Hi. I'm still the older one though, by 30 minutes, so don't worry. Don't worry. On today's video, we're going to be talking about the new year and setting some goals and what we want to do, goals that we're going to set for ourselves, what actions we're going to take in the coming months to get closer and closer towards accomplishing those goals. And then as we go through the months, we're going to be doing a monthly video about where we're at with our goals, what we've done that month to take steps towards completing them, and then we'll be sharing them with you so that you can follow along with us. It's also a good way for us to stay motivated and for us to really hold ourselves accountable towards those 2020 goals. But I also feel like it's really important to set goals that might naturally come to you or that are small steps that you can take so that you're not overwhelming yourself right off the bat or trying to accomplish something that you don't realistically think that you can accomplish.
Definitely. I have so many people in my life that say, okay, Kayla, today's the day, because you know, if you're like a fitness person at all in your personal life, every single person wants to tell you about their fitness goals because they think you will have some personal interest because you're into fitness. So I have so many people in my personal life who come to me and say, okay, Kayla, today I'm gonna go so hard. I'm gonna go to the gym. It's Monday. I'm gonna go like 7 days, the whole week. I'm gonna go every day. I'm gonna eat healthy. I'm gonna eat my 1200 calories, drink my 7 glasses of water. And then by Tuesday, Wednesday, they stop going to the gym, they're at McDonald's getting a Big Mac again, and they've fallen off. And that happens to me so often. And if they would have maybe taken a few steps towards those goals, such as only going to the gym twice that week, or making sure to just drink 4 to 5 glasses of water and then working your way up, if you accomplish those small baby goals, you are 10 times more likely to end up finishing those goals than you are to back out of them and not end up accomplishing them. I sat down before January 1st and decided I was going to write all my goals in this book. And then I can kind of use this book to articulate my thoughts and feelings as I move through this journey. So I like to always write out my goals in terms of headings. So I have physical goals, mental goals, professional goals, financial goals. In terms of my physical goals, I used to compete in bikini competitions. I've always kind of heavily been into fitness, and it's probably been about 7 or 8 years now. But since competing, and I know a lot of people in the bodybuilding industry will touch on this and tend to talk about this, there's just this idea about competing and then not competing anymore and then having this really disordered view about exercise and eating and food, that I do harbor a lot of those disordered thoughts and feelings about exercise and food. It's easy to tell yourself that you don't think that way about yourself, that the way that you think is normal. This really extreme view about exercise and about food is okay if that's how you want to live your life, and that being an extreme person and doing a lot of exercise or eating very minimally is totally okay, as long as it's okay for you and it's not harming other people. So this year, a physical goal of mine is to not diet for a year. Second pair to that goal is to alter my body composition more. Instead of focusing on what is the weight on the scale, I'm going to be focusing on, can I add more muscle and can I take fat away? My mini goals are to decrease the cardio that I'm doing, keep weight lifting, and then to increase my calories. I had injured myself in 2016 and I tore like my meniscus, my MCL, and my ACL. So I ended up having reconstructive surgery in August of 2016. So I spent a lot of time rehabbing my knee. I never got it to a place where I felt really comfortable with it. I never got that full range of motion back. I decided to take up yoga. It's like I couldn't even sit in a normal cross-legged position. My left knee had always locked at that particular point. It was always very uncomfortable for me. And then after yoga, I got that full range of motion back, so I could sit properly cross-legged. It doesn't hurt me anymore. My other physical goals are to do some front splits as well as side splits. Getting my heels to go down in downward dog, because that's a natural progression and something that I haven't been able to do for a year and a half. And I want to be able to put my hands on the ground in a full forward fold, completely relaxed by the end of the year. I reminder steps that I'm going to take to reach those goals are to stretch for at least 20 minutes, 4 to 5 times a week, attend yoga at least 2 times per week, and then document all of this again with photos. In terms of my mental goals, again, this ties in with bodybuilding and really addressing that disordered eating, disordered exercise, and those disordered thoughts around both of those. So I'm going to control my issues with food, overeating when I'm not really hungry, and eating in situations where maybe I'm stressed or maybe I'm uncomfortable, and then this binge eating behavior as well, eating when I'm not hungry or eating just because it's there. So kind of a small goal that I'm going to take to reach that is to see a therapist about this. So I found a therapist who addresses this type of issue, and I'm going to be setting a meeting with them and then reading books in that particular area so I can kind of address all of those underlying issues. As well, for my mental goals, I want to read one book every 2 months, so that's 6 books a year. And the reason why I set that goal so minimally is because I know I can reach it. In terms of professional goals, I'd like to obtain an associate position at the firm I work at now. I'm currently an articling student, and then at the end of that articling year, I'm called to the bar where I sit in front of a judge, and my principal, who is the individual who looks after me in the firm, he kind of pleads my case towards the judge, and then the judge indicates whether I've passed the bar or not. So that's going to happen sometime in July. And then once that happens, I'm hoping that my firm will hire me on as a full-time associate. So in terms of my professional goals then too, I'd like to volunteer for organizations that are supportive of my goals in law, but also my personal goals. So I'm going to volunteer for an organization called LEAF, which is Women's Legal Education Fund. And LEAF is an organization that supports women's equality in life and in law. And they advocate a lot for women's equality, which is something that's really important to me. And then in terms of my financial goals, I only have one financial goal, and it's to pay off my student loans completely. So I hired a financial advisor who is really incredible, and she really sat me down and we planned out my whole financial future. She showed me what it would look like if I paid off my loans in advance, or if I took some time paying off my student loans, and we decided that financially it made more sense for me to take more time to pay off my student loans. So it's going to take me about to November of next year to do that, and then once that's done, I'm going to be able to do a lot more financially and take more steps in my personal life with that. So I'm really excited about that. And you can definitely follow along on our Instagram, so we're going to be posting a lot there too as well. So these videos, Instagram, and feel free to share what your goals are with us. We really want to see what you're going to be working on this year and follow along with your journey. That will be really motivating for us. So thanks for watching. Gonna go through my list and tell you guys what my goals are for 2020. I do have some financial, some professional, physical, mental goals for 2020, and I'll talk briefly about each one of them. So my financial goal for this year is to make extra money. I do work at Starbucks currently. I am a manager there, and I did finish my degree last year, and I finished it. I got a degree in management with a major in marketing. This past summer, I did start a YouTube channel, and I have just been kind of gaining traction in terms of making videos, getting better at editing. So my primary focus in 2020 is earning that extra income or branching out into a social media platform kind of atmosphere. And that is the first time that I've ever really admitted that, because I have gotten quite a few questions from my friends and family, or just people who have watched me on Instagram for a little bit, saying, what are you doing? What are you planning on doing? You're finishing school, you're doing this YouTube, like, what's your life about? The small steps that I'm going to take, of course, I'm going to be posting videos weekly, hopefully one or two videos on YouTube a week. How I'm going to stay on track is time blocking. I'm going to put that time aside weekly or daily to make sure that I'm putting ideas out there, figuring out what my videos are going to be about, and actually setting aside that time to edit and film those videos. Because if you're not setting yourself up for success by ensuring that you have that time scheduled, when are you going to make the time to do it? My physical goal, so like my sister touched upon, after I finished competing, fell into that mental state where your body looks the absolute best for one day, and then you think you have to sustain that, and then what you end up doing is binge eating and then suffering and punishing yourself and binge eating, and the cycle just continues until you gain like 20 to 30 pounds, and then you're upset with the way that your physique looks, but you actually can't get out of that mental trap of doing hours and hours of cardio and working out too much. So I did fall into that back in, I think, 2016, and so it has been about a year of
not really dieting, not suffering, not doing extra cardio, and I do have, I think I'm in a very good mental place as well as physical place. 2 years ago, I found out that I had a hypothyroid, which really isn't a big deal. You just fix it with medication, but the problem comes in with that your body is still substituting this medication and not producing this component in your body on its own. So I have suffered a little bit in respect to that. I do still have low energy sometimes. I am anemic, so I take iron supplements as well as my synthroid supplement. My hair, as a result, is a different texture. It does grow out in like a darker, thick texture in some areas. My skin does suffer a little bit. I am still really tired, and I do find that making any fluctuations in my food in terms of weight loss, it is a little tricky sometimes, and I do have to watch my body a lot more and what it does. So I think this year I'm going to focus on bulking. I have been bulking. If you follow me on Instagram, you will know that I have been bulking for the last like 2 or so months. I went from about 133 to 135 pounds to about 140 to 141-ish now. So I have been slowly increasing my calories. I started about 13 to 1500 back in about June or July, and now I'm at about 2500 calories. I have slowly been increasing my calories, slowly increasing my strength, gaining that momentum, and then in about February, middle of February, I'll start to decrease my calories again, maybe add in some cardio if need be, and I want to get to about 125 pounds. The small steps that I'm going to take to make sure that I'm reaching that goal is during my cut phase, I'm going to be taking weekly progress photos as well as weighing myself, as well as measuring the parts of my body like my hips, my bust, my legs, my arms, so I can not only keep track through my weight, but also through the progression in my photos. And I'm also going to continue taking weekly updated photos of what my body looks like every Sunday like I have been doing. My mental goal for this year is I am going to continue to see a therapist. About 6 months ago, Devin and I identified in our relationship that we needed help with our communication skills. So we decided that we were going to go see a couples therapist. A lot of times I think that people shy away from going to a therapist because they think that that's the first sign that their relationship is in trouble. I initially thought that I had this huge stigma around therapy and therapists and what they were going to do for me. And when we went to go see her in our first few sessions, she gave us so many tools that we could put in our toolbox to really enter into healthy conversations with each other where we weren't placing blame on the other person, we weren't bringing the relationship down, and we were moving in a forward progression. I think it is super important to recognize that every relationship that you have needs work, and especially the one with your significant other. You don't want to fall prey to just doing the same things over and over again and not ever being able to change or move forward with that relationship. There is a healthy way to do it, and I think having a therapist is such an amazing idea. And I also had started to see one about 6 months ago. We'll start going back to a therapist in the new year, especially because she gave me so many ways to deal with things. I do suffer from anxiety a lot. I am taking anti-anxiety medication for that, as well as I've developed a problem with pulling out my hair. I pull out my hair in chunks when I'm anxious, and I need to really start getting a handle on that and addressing those compulsive disorders so that I can have a very mental, healthy 2020 and well into my future. So that is the mental aspect of my goal for 2020. Alongside my physical goals, I also want to work on my acne. As you can see right now on my face, I have some breakouts. Last year, I really started to tackle my acne problem. I started to change up my face routine. I started watching more YouTube videos about people and their success stories with their acne, and I decided that this was going to be the year that I really tackled it, that I really got this under control. I'm going to see a dermatologist. I booked my appointment back in November, and my appointment's still not until like the end of February, but I did book an appointment to see a dermatologist, and I'm going to start seeing somebody about removing some scars. I have a pocket on the left part of my cheek that sinks in a little bit, so I want to see a dermatologist about getting that fixed and just kind of having a better skincare routine. That is so important. Your skin is, like they say, the largest organ in your whole body, and you need to take care of it. So that was something I also wanted to work on in 2020. So those are our goals for 2020. Thank you so much for watching this video. If you did like this video, maybe give it a thumbs up. Don't forget to hit the subscribe button. Follow us along on this journey as we go through 2020 and evolve and take charge of our goals. Oh my God. Done. All right, guys. Thank you so much for watching. Bye.